Hey, what's up guys, Jeremy here. In this video, we will create the targets required to move our little colored boxes around. I will show you two tricks in particular, how to create targets accurately and how to use reference frame to copy and paste multiple targets at the same time and save a bunch of time in such applications. Let's get started. So we start with our organized box station. Now that we added a tool, we can start creating the targets required to move the boxes around. So one thing that you could do is simply double click the robot. Make sure the right reference frame is activated. So part here, so active reference frame, or selecting by selecting part here. And then you can, if you know exactly where this box is, you can just enter the values here for the target right in the middle here for something like, I think it's something like 85 and then 75 and then 75. It's something like that. Like, yes, not even there. It's like 80 instead. So if you know it, you can just enter the value, but you don't always know it. So one of the things you can do is use the measure tool. So I'm going to close that for now. And I will go to tools and then measure. In the future, I will have a video specifically on the measure tool. So this is a very useful feature. But for now, what we'll do is simply use the detect plane option we have here. So, and we will go on top of one of our part. And as you can see here, it creates a small dot directly in the center or right on this in the center of this frame here or this surface. So if I click, you will have the absolute position here. So the absolute position with respect to the robot base or the station origin, in fact. So in this case, it's 415 in X, minus 125 in Y, and 80 in Z. So I can copy here, again, using the same trick as I already showed you. So copy here, I can close that. I can open up my station. Here, as my robot base is coincident with the station origin, so at 000, the absolute measurement I picked here will work with respect to this reference frame UR5 base. I can simply paste that here, and the tool, the active tool, will go exactly where I took my measurement. So if I went instead tool measure and selected this center point here, I can copy the value here, paste it there, and now I'm at the center point of this other box. If I clear selection, select this one here, copy, paste, I'm right here. So it's very important for that to work that the frame of the robot or robot base is at 000 with respect to the station origin and that the robot UR5 base here is activated. Then I need to activate my part reference frame because I want to create the target with respect to the part, and I can create my first target here. Oops, bad choice. Let's delete that here. Double click again. The reason why it didn't create the target in the right spot is because this one was activated, but I had this one selected here. So I need to go back, measure, select here, copy, paste. Oops, I need to paste here. Fine. And now close, right click, activate reference frame. And now I need to create a target. So even I do some mistakes here and there. So this one will be pick, let's say LY for light yellow, and double click the robot. We'll move up to 280, let's say, and this will be the transition point. So this will be app light yellow. So now we have two targets, both representing one position to go pick the yellow box. So now we need to do the same for the other ones. So what we could easily do is simply use the measurement tool again, pick this center point here, move up, pick the center point, move up, pick the center point, move up. That would work. It will work really well, in fact. But I have another tricks to show you. So if you create a new reference frame here and make it part of the reference frame part and make sure that it's at 000, so either double click here and bring zeros everywhere or right click on the frame and then select reset. So we'll call it copy paste frame or frame copy paste, let's say. So what I'll do now is I'll select the both targets I created, Control C, and then I will select the new frame, Control V. For now, the only thing I did was creating two new targets that are exactly where the other ones were. But if I move the frame here, and let's say move it along the y-axis, not the x-axis, the y-axis, I can kind of position it right where I need it. So I know here I am the one who designed that little trace, so I know exactly the distance between those two, it's 125. But if I want to know, what I can do is simply go to Tools and then measure, select one surface and then select the other one, and I will know that the distance, oh, here that doesn't work, like it will tell me the distance is exactly the same. But if I go instead Tool and measure and select midpoint here, between this midpoint here and this midpoint here, there's like 125 here. So same distance in the other direction. By the way, those here measure 75 by 75 by 75, and the distance here is 50 millimeters in between. So I need to move here my frame 125. Now the targets are right in the middle. So let's simply rename those quickly. So it's going to be light green, so we'll go for LG, and oops, wrong F key, and this will be approach light green. So now I have two targets. What I can do is select those two, or right click, change support, and position them in part. So now the two targets are there with respect to dark part frame. So I can select those two again, and then I can Control V in the frame copy paste, and I can move the frame copy paste this time 125 millimeters more, so 250 here, and now I have my two new targets created here. So that's perfect. So I can rename those, so it will be dark orange and dark orange. Perfect. Select those two targets. Remember, we need to do an absolute transfer, or what we call a set parent static. So we change the parent of the target or the object without changing the absolute position in the station. So just like that, we have six targets created. I will right click here and reset this frame or bring everything back to zero. So reset. I will copy all the targets I have. Control C, Control V, or paste them in frame copy paste. And this time I will move along the X axis for 125. You can see now I moved six targets at once. So that's very useful. So now I can rename them. So this one is the light pick. It's going to be light orange. The second one will be light orange too. I'm going to move my mouse out of there. Here we have pick. It's going to be dark yellow, and then F2 dark yellow, and then here is going to be dark green and dark green. So now I have all the targets required to pick the boxes and the targets required to transition between the position. So I can select all of those, change support and part. So now they will be part of our part reference frame. Okay, great. So now I can do the same once again. I can select the same targets I picked at the beginning. So the first six targets, Control C and then Control V here in my frame copy paste. And instead of 125, I'll go for 250. So let's say that I created six other targets. right here. So that's awesome. So what I can do now, I need to rename those. So the approach will still be a name approach, but this will be a drop. And the first one will be light green, because we'll start with the light green here at the bottom. So this one here. Here, this will be approach app, just green. This one here will be drop light orange. So drop light orange. This one will be app orange. Oops, here I want to be consistent in the naming. And then we'll go for drop light yellow and app yellow. Okay, so now we have six targets. So right click, change support part here. Perfect, that's awesome. We have all our targets. We just need three more targets here for the second row of the drop. So what I'll do is I'll simply keep the frame exactly where it is. In fact, no, I'm gonna reset the frame position here. I will take all the drop light targets, Control C, Control V in my copy paste. And this time I will move the frame up 75 millimeters. So one height of a cube to create here. It's gonna be drop dark yellow. It's gonna be drop light, dark orange, and drop dark green. And select all of those targets, change support part, and now I can delete my frame, copy paste, and I have all my targets to go and pick the boxes and all the targets to drop the boxes here. So I can reorganize them here. I will go for dark yellow, light yellow. So this will be in the same order here. Light orange, dark orange, light green, dark green. Perfect. And approach green. Cool. Okay, so that's what I wanted to show you. So those are two very useful tricks. So you can use the measure tool to define a picking position or rod position. And you can use the copy paste and frame motion to duplicate a lot of targets. And you can do the same with objects, by the way, a lot of objects or a lot of targets in a very short amount of time. So within like 12 minutes, I was able to show you all of that. And if you were to do all the targets one by one, it would have taken like way longer than that, I can assure you, by experience. Okay, so in the next video, we will start creating the sub programs to pick the boxes and start organizing all of that, all of those points or all of those boxes. That being said, have a great day, guys. Mm-hmm.